The Earth was once empty. There was a very harsh climate. Unbearable natural phenomena occurred. Temperatures could reach minus 100 at night and 800 degrees during the day. The first elements were synthesized at incredibly high temperatures. In the Earth's crust, there were elements such as carbon, magnesium, and copper. By reacting with each other, they formed rocks. After a while, iron rained down from the sky. The Earth was being prepared for the evolution of robots. In temperatures sometimes exceeding 1,000 degrees, oxygenation occurred due to the wind and steel was produced. From bauxite ore underground in some swampy areas, electrolysis produced the first aluminium elements. Chemical compounds and electrolysis created new metals.
This all went on for centuries. It took 700,000 years for the first particles to form. The climate became milder. Environmental factors began to mold matter. Electrical contacts and sparks began to jump. With electric currents, the first software for robots appeared. After interactions of genetic variations in the structure of metals, the first robotic tissues appeared. By strange coincidences, the shape and design of the organs were drawn. Mathematical calculations produced the most ergonomic forms. Bad drawings were eliminated. Successful drawings won the race. Software was designed according to the laws of physics and shaped the structure of organs. The wire connections between robot organs developed into communication and control systems. Incompatible parts were eliminated. Compatible parts linked together with electrical couplings. These parts got bored of immobility. They wanted to move, and tiny electric motors appeared at their joints. One movement followed another.
This is a pre-Homo robotus, 300,000 years old. These are from the same period. Then, the species began to diversify. First, feet adapted to the Earth and each other. It took 100 years of evolution to run well. Legs evolved. This is the hunter-gatherer Robo Big Dog. He evolved by battling continuously. Environmental factors eliminated the weak. The strong survived. At the same time, Robo Dinosaurus emerged in another geography, but it didn't last long. A giant asteroid landed on Earth and wiped them all out. Small-sized robots that resisted environmental conditions continued to reproduce. The eager, primitive robot could build and develop its own hardware and software. Some robots that started to live in water added depth and pressure sensors on their bodies. They acquired tiny balancing tanks and a water-resistant energy battery. Those who wanted to live on land stripped away their sensors and swimming apparatus. He built himself legs for walking on land. These transformations didn't happen one after another. They occurred in various species over millennia.
Everything happened on its own. There was no plan or program. Different species evolved without a creator with wisdom and power. Each species could evolve as they wished. Everyone became whatever they wanted to be. Robots aiming to fly have achieved their goal after thousands of years of effort. But only Homo robotus, humans couldn't think of flying. Therefore, unfortunately, he remained wingless. People have never had such a desire in the last 5,000 years on Earth. If they did, they would have developed tiny little flaps on their arms. This is Petman, also known as Robo Erectus. He developed his own software and hardware for extreme conditions. Some species wanted to run fast, he designed themselves accordingly. He increased the power of the motors in his muscles. Robots continued their lineage by fighting against Homo sapiens. Robots could not develop the ability to repair themselves, they couldn't mend their scratches, but Homo sapiens updated their software and figured it out. Destroyed tissues are regenerated. Robots that could not adapt to harsh conditions disappeared from the face of the Earth through natural selection.
Dear viewers, the evolution of robots has come to an end. The Atlas robot, which managed to develop and evolve itself, made its public debut.
More than 100 years passed, and the species that called itself Atlas dominated the Earth. These are battery-powered. The battery lasts for an hour. Its joints are powered by about 40 electric motors. They have greatly improved their engines in the last 200 years. Their brains have suddenly developed multi-core processors. The memory card has evolved to a terabyte. After gaining all of that, they acquired an accelerometer and were able to stabilize themselves like humans. There are unscientific claims regarding the evolution of atlases. It was said that metals cannot evolve on their own. However, for the scientific community, metal evolution is now an indisputable scientific fact. There are also those who say that for a robot to exist, a human-type creator is required. If we accept that as true, then the question arises as to who created man, which is why we can't ask.
Robots evolved from inorganic elements. Humans evolved from carbon-based elements. The evolution of robots is no harder than the evolution of Homo sapiens. Humans came from a single cell. Amino acids evolved first. They agreed among themselves and built the first cell. And after a while, out of loneliness, they got bored and wanted to become multicellular. They waited patiently, and after a billion years, they got their wish. They didn't stop there. Then fish, and these. Then reptiles, birds, and mammals, and Homo sapiens. Each species wrote its own specialized DNA and RNA. Species that couldn't keep up with this evolution disappeared. Dinosaurs, like robo big dogs, wiped off the face of the Earth by an asteroid. Each animal invented its own organs. Without brains, there would be no life. They developed brains according to their needs.
Somehow, it all happened. Only man wanted to gain the ability to use his mind and speak, and he achieved this. And through evolution, every living thing acquired ears suitable for its own design. Every living thing needed eyes to sustain life. Two dimples appeared below the forehead of Homo sapiens. Millions of living beings gained millions of different types of eyes. Man was smarter, but for some reason, couldn't manage to fly. He tried jumping, but because he did not think about it, during the evolution process, he could not grow even a chicken wing. Homo sapiens has vital organs. It wouldn't exist without lungs, liver, or a stomach. The small intestine was laid, then it had to thicken, and the large intestine was formed. It was impossible to live without kidneys. They implanted themselves with two kidneys in case one was not enough. They mounted whichever organs they wanted, as if buying them from a market. The body needed a main engine, and that didn't keep the other organs waiting long. The heart took 50,000 years to evolve.
How did the other organs survive until the heart worked? How did they survive? Because if one piece is missing, the whole body dies. It is not yet known how Homo sapiens managed to survive until all the organs were complete. It's a scientific fact that the organs of the human body are formed by evolution. But how it all happened is not fully understood. Evolution from single cell to perfect man without planning and without software, just like in robots. No creator was needed. There was no intelligent external intervention. the only decision makers were nature and natural selection. The greatest evidence of evolution is billions of years of time. The longer the time, the less need for reason and engineering. The evolution of Homo robotus was just like the evolution of Homo sapiens, but Homo robotus are not yet evolved enough to give birth to baby robots like humans. It is an absolute fact that it's going to happen over the next millions of years.
Force us to work. We exist.